an offering was not, I know this is extremely un-Lutheran and unchurch-like, there is no offering in this service. But I do not want to take that lightly because some people consider that a very important part of their worship. So there will be an offering plate. We'll do it the old style, the way it was done in Jewish synagogues in Jesus' day. There will be an offering plate on a table as you leave. And if you have an offering, you are welcome to put it in that offering plate as you leave. We're going to have announcements at the end of the service today. I just want to welcome you to our Cave Quest Vacation Bible School. Let's begin with a prayer. Gracious Heavenly Father, we do thank you for our children and our workers and our directors for this Vacation Bible School. We pray that you bless this program, make it meaningful for us all. We are thankful that you are the light, the love, the power, the hope in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
We learned what a cave quest is. When a new cave is discovered, lots of questions are asked. How big is the cave? How did it form? Are there animals in it? To find these answers, cavers or spelunkers had to get some light into that darkness. Just like we have questions as we explore our lives and world around us, we learned that Jesus is the light of the entire world and our lives. We rely on our map, a Bible, God's Word. All week we have learned that we can follow Jesus, the light of the world, even when we face darkness.
On our first day, we learned that Jesus gives us hope.
Follow him!
When things get tough in school, with family, or with big changes happen that scare us, Jesus gives us hope. He is bigger than our problems, and we can trust in him. God provided salamanders go through lots of changes before they can explore a cave or breathe outside the water. They have a lot to look forward to. When you see Sal, we can remember that Jesus gives us hope.
Follow him!
Our Bible verse today comes from Psalm 71, verse 5.
Oh Lord, you alone are my hope.
Remind us how we can trust Jesus and that he is our light, even when the world seems dark. Sing about it.
Throughout the week, we learned about people in the Bible and people around us today that trust in the Lord. Reminds us that God knows each and every one of us has a special light to shine. We have a special song to remember that God loves each and every one of them.
Thank you.
On our second day, we learned that Jesus gives us courage.
Follow him!
Courage doesn't mean we think we are bigger, tougher, or stronger than our problems, but we trust that Jesus is. Martha, a beautiful moth, isn't afraid of the dark. They love to fly high in the deep, dark night. Martha helps us remember that Jesus gives us courage.
Follow him!
Just like Peter used courage to trust Jesus and step out of the boat, we must remember to keep trusting him and know what Jesus is right by our side to give us courage. From Matthew 14, verse 27.
On our next day, we discovered that Jesus gives us directions.
Follow him!
Today, we are often bombarded with mixed ideas about what is right or wrong. We need to know which way to go in this dark, confusion world. Jesus shows us the truth. We make the Bible Buddy radar, bats live in caves where dark and hunt for food in the dark. They make tiny noises that echo off the walls. By listening to those noises, bats which know two directions to go. Radar helps us remember that Jesus gives us directions.
Follow him.
Jesus told people how to live, treat others, and how to talk to him. Our keepers. Is Proverbs 36.
He will show you which path to take.
Nice job.
If we can have our preschool kids back up.
First, there we go. I would like the young people to come on up and we'll have a children's sermon. In fact, right up over here. Good morning. How are you? All right. Did you have a fun week? Those of you that went to Vacation Bible School, yeah, and the special night was Owl Night on Thursday night, and we had four owls. I don't know why they did not invite who the owl. Isn't that? So don't make any quick movements like the woman from the zoo told us, because you don't want the owl to come and land on you. Right? Who must not be reading his script? Or
who?
Oh, there you go. Thank you. It is who the owl.
Who?
Maybe who can help us. Let's see if who knows what character came to us on Monday night.
Who?
Yes, who? Who was it?
Who?
I don't think who is going to be any help. There we go. It was Sal the Salamander. And as we already heard, his Bible verse that he taught us was, O Lord, you alone are my hope. And Jesus gives us hope.
Who?
Who? Who?
Yes. Who, you are impossible.
Who?
Who came to us on Tuesday night? Let's see if you remember that.
Who?
Well, on Tuesday night came Martha. And remember, she had the Bible verse that had the words of Jesus, take courage, I am here. And her saying was, Jesus gives us courage. Very good. And who came on Wednesday? Who?
Who?
All right. It was Radar. And he had the verse from Proverbs that said, God will show you what path to take. And his saying was, Jesus gives us direction. Okay.
Who? Who?
All right, who? Who came on Thursday night?
Who? Olivia the owl.
Oh, he remembered Olivia the owl.
Who?
I should have known you would have liked Olivia.
Who?
And Olivia told us about the love of God. We know real love. We know what real love is because Jesus gave up his life for us. And Olivia's saying for us was, Jesus gives us love. All right, who came to us on Friday?
Who?
All right, I'll tell you. It was Ray, the glowworm.
Who?
And his saying was, our great power is from God, not from ourselves. 2 Corinthians 4:7. And his saying was, Jesus gives us power.
Follow him.
It was a good week in Vacation Bible School, don't you think?
Who?
And you all got memory buddies.
Who?
Let us pray. Repeat after me. Gracious God, we thank you for Vacation Bible School. All the fun we had and all that we learned. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You can go back to your seats.
Who?
And who, you can go.
Help.
They allowed me time for a sermon. I don't know how popular that will be. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We'll move through a sermon really quite rapidly. By the way, that's a glowworm, not a lightning bug. There is a difference. I spoke on Galatians 5, verse 1, 13 through 25. We talked about Christian freedom. And let me read that to you quickly. For freedom, the Apostle Paul said, Christ has set us free. Stand firm, therefore, and do not submit again to the yoke of slavery. For you are called to freedom, brothers and sisters. Only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for self-indulgence, but through love, become slaves to one another. For the whole law is summed up in a single commandment. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. If, however, you bite and devour one another, take care that you are not consumed by one another. Live by the Spirit, I say, and do not gratify the desires of the flesh. For what the flesh desires is opposed to the Spirit, and what the Spirit desires is opposed to the flesh. For these are opposed to each other to prevent you from doing what you want. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not subject to the law. Now, the works of the flesh are obvious: fornication, impurity, licentiousness, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, anger, quarrels, dissensions, factions, envy, drunkenness, carousing, and things like these. I am warning you as I warned you before. Those who do such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. By contrast, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. There is no law against such things, and those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let us also be guided by the Spirit. Two lists. The passions of the flesh and the gifts or the fruit of the Spirit. So on those two lists, we've got Rick, or Ted, who says to Rick, that's quite a list. Ted asks, the first one or the second one? The second. I'm familiar with the first one. And so it is with our struggle. And I apologized to the people last night for being much too theological, and so I'm going to pare this sermon way down for us today, even a little bit down from this morning. Freedom in Christ. The Apostle Paul tells us that we were created to be free, free in Christ. And he had a war with certain teachers in the Galatian church who were trying to tell them that it was all about law. And he's trying to tell them, no, it's all about the freedom we have in Christ. We look back at Adam and Eve, those proverbial first parents, and their sin. And I realize there's all kinds of debate. Some people feel they're not historical and others do. And I say that's irrelevant because we all know. We have that, as the Reformers said, that old Adam within us. And within us, we've committed sin. That's original with us. There we have that struggle, that war. We want to do all those things that are the desires of the flesh. And it's not so much, and very often they're there because they are, We call them sin, but they're there because they're the things that help us cope in the world. Oh, by the way, I put the power symbol up there, Ray, who says, Jesus gives us his power. Because the Apostle Paul would say, our only hope is in the power of Christ. By the way, it's the first step, and people in Narcotics Anonymous or Alcoholics Anonymous will tell you it is the most important step in their recovery, and that is to admit that you are powerless and admit that you need a higher power. In our case, that is God coming to us through Christ. And it's believed in AA and NA that if you get this first step right, the rest of the 12 steps are much easier. They all hinge on this first step. So sin is simply sinful control is firing God and putting yourself in charge of your life. Sin is the avoidance of pain in life. Don't we go through life filled with pain? God gives us that pain so that it would be channeled into realizing God is needed in our lives. And that pain can be the hurt we have from our human relationships, or it can be the pain from hunger, which causes me to do foolish things in order to feed myself. The Apostle Paul with that list lists all kinds of things. I mentioned sex once in my sermon this morning, and one of the little ones told her mother, he talked about sex today. So I wasn't supposed to talk about that at 11, she thought. So there's two answers. Forgiveness. Soren Kierkegaard said, the only way we're going to get any place in our spiritual lives is to realize that when we think about God, very often when people think about God, they quiver and are fearsome because they feel God is only judging, saying, live this way or else. He says, only until we get to the point that our first thought of God is forgiveness, that we really understand what the baptismal life is all about. I'm God's forgiven person. That's the most important step. You know, the tragedy out of Orlando, there's tragedy upon tragedy. Many of the, there was an article in the Wall Street Journal that talked about how parents, and they interviewed parents in church and, right after they were done praying, and they came out and said, we never knew our loved one had a secret. We never knew our loved one was gay or lesbian. Can you imagine holding that secret in such an important part of their life? And of course, now the family deals with that whole question. We were judging them, and they thought we would hate them. The Apostle Paul says, no, we're free in Christ, free to love. So forgiveness is the first answer, and then the freedom to love. And let me just end with a story. I've told you it before. Marion Preninger was raised, she was born in the castle in Hungary in 1913. Had a very, very affluent life. She literally was born with a gold spoon in her mouth. Had everything given to her, maids and chauffeurs. If they ever went anywhere, the family brought their own linen. It's a way to deal with bed bugs. Never thought of that. She met a doctor in Vienna, Otto Preminger. They moved to the United States, to Hollywood. Otto Preminger became a famous director. She got involved with alcohol, drugs, sex, promiscuity. A pretty decadent life. Otto Preminger got fed up and kicked her out and divorced her. She went and became a socialite in Europe. Lived her life. I guess we could say a rather decadent life. Until one day, she heard Albert Schweitzer was coming to town. She called up and said, I'd like to meet Albert Schweitzer. And she was told, oh, he's over in a little village in a church playing their organ. She went there and just turned to music for him as he played. Spent the day with him, learned things from him. He invited her to supper. And she said, from that visit, she had met the very one who was the answer to her life. Now here's one who Paul's list of the sins of the flesh, she was very involved with. She knew that list very well. Albert Schweitzer said, well, why don't you come to Africa? So she went to the mission field in Africa with him. And here's what she spent the rest of her life doing. She changed bandages, bathed babies, fed lepers, and became free. She wrote an autobiography. All I ever wanted was everything. But everything didn't satisfy her. Finally, when Christ set her free to be a servant, she found freedom. So as we struggle with that list of fleshly desires, and struggle to cultivate and grow the fruit of the Spirit in our lives, the Apostle Paul says, learn to love one another, because Christ wants to free us from this list over here with forgiveness and grace to free you to love. Amen.
Taught us that Jesus. Day four taught us that Jesus gives us love. Follow him. Bible Buddy Olivia is an owl with a heart-shaped face. Hearts are symbols of love. Jesus' love is powerful and perfect and will always be with us no matter what. Jesus loves us so much, he died on the cross so that our sins could be forgiven. Today's Bible verse from 1 John 3:16 says,
we know what love is because Jesus gave up his life for us.
We're going to continue with the prayers. Gracious God, you commission us for our ministry and daily life. You also call us to pass our faith and ministry on to the next generation. We thank you for a vacation Bible school week where we made an effort to pass on our faith. Inspire us in our equipping of others. Lord, in your mercy, God of the nations, the distractions of this world make us realize we are dependent upon you. Our heart aches for the trouble spots of the world, including the families of Orlando, victims, and the news that foreign supporters of ISIS have taken over Syria, Libya, murdering, torturing, crucifying Christians and Muslims alike. We pray for peace. Lord, in your mercy, through the fruit of your Spirit, make us healers in the world. Bring love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control into the lives of all. We pray for healing. We pray for all those people that we have on our prayer list, as well as those that we name in our hearts. And gather us in the promise of life forever with you. We pray for those who mourn. Lord, in your mercy. And now we pray that you guide this congregation by your Spirit. Make us neighbors to each other, ready to be and receive strangers, and show us how to love our neighbors as you intend. Lord, in your mercy. We're going to continue with the communion portion of our service, and I want you to know that everyone is welcome to come to the table for communion. Please rise. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Holy, mighty, and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who on the cross opened his arms to all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. All is ready. Our Lord welcomes us all. Please come. You may be seated.
Jesus, we love you. He is.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, through the gifts of his body and blood, strengthen, keep, and unite us now and forever. Amen. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this gift of life. We pray that you fill us with your power to cultivate within us the growth of the fruit of the Spirit so we can share your love with all we meet. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Learning how to hope, have courage, follow his directions and love is the light that will save us in our challenging world today. Knowing all of this is powerful. Power is a big thing for us today. We are surrounded by images of superheroes, games of characters with superpowers, and high-tech inventions that use power. We know that God's power is the strongest of all.
Discover that Jesus gives us his power.
Follow him!
Jesus has given all of has his followers, even kids, the awesome power to share his love and his map.
Bible Buddy Ray is a glowworm. God gave glowworms a unique power to glow. They have the power to light up the tops of the caves where they live as much as they want day and night. Ray helps us remember that Jesus gives us his power.
Follow him!
Our Bible verse today is important to remember that there are two important reasons for Jesus' ascension. It first marks that the end of Jesus' earthly ministry, and the second marks the beginning of the Holy Spirit's ministry, though each one of us. We will continue what he started from Acts 1, verses 1 through 11.
Our great power is from God, not from ourselves.
And for one of our last songs, if we can have our preschool tadpoles, Lucy, Zachary, anyone who is in our Miss Nadine's tadpoles.
I hope you thought that was pretty good. I only have two announcements. One is potluck follows this, and there is a sign-up sheet for Lutheran Day at the ballpark. If you are a Cardinals fan, even if you're not, you can go and sign up. It should be a fun night. And then I would like Rachel and Margaret to come forward. They were the ones that did all the work to direct this program this year. And they did considerable work, by the way. Enjoy the flowers. Let's see. Will I have a benediction? And then I think the kids are going to sing one more song. So please rise for this benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
Kids, spread across the front, and if you'll join us, the words will be up on the screen. Come on, kids, up to the front, and we want to thank the band, too, for learning all of our music this week.
Go in peace. Serve the Lord.